Hello, this video will provide a brief introduction to ClinVar and how you can review a ClinVar record. ClinVar is a publicly accessible database funded by the National Center for Biotechnology Information, NCBI, containing genetic variants and their classifications. As a reminder, genetic variants are changes in our genetic material, our DNA. There are two main categories of genetic variants: copy number variants and sequence variants. Copy number variants are genetic changes where a person has large missing or extra pieces of genetic material. If a person is missing genetic material, this is called a deletion. If they have an extra piece of genetic material, this is called a duplication. If we think about our entire genome as a library, a copy number variant would equate to extra or missing books on a shelf. Another type of variant is called a sequence variant. Sequence variants are small changes in the DNA. Our DNA is made up of the letters A, T, G, and C. A sequence variant changes a single letter or a few letters in the DNA sequence. In the example displayed on the screen, the sequence variant involves a C being exchanged for a T. If our genome is a library, a sequence variant is like a spelling error in one sentence in one of the books. All of us have many genetic variants. Some variants impact how a gene works in our body and contribute to disease, while others do not independently cause disease. Genetic testing laboratories use all available information to determine how a specific variant impacts health. The conclusion reached by the laboratory is called the variant classification. It is important to note that new evidence can change our understanding of a variant and alter its classification over time. Classifications fall into three main buckets: benign, uncertain, and pathogenic. Benign means that the copy number or sequence variant is not believed to impact a gene's function or independently affect health. A pathogenic variant may explain a patient's symptoms, increase an individual's chance of developing a specific condition, or increase the chance of having a child with a specific condition. If there is not enough information to put a variant into the pathogenic or benign categories, it is called a variant of uncertain significance, or VUS. This means there is not enough evidence to say that a variant is associated with health or developmental differences. More information is needed. If not done as part of initial testing, parental testing often can be helpful in increasing our understanding of a VUS. Understanding if a variant was inherited from a parent or new and unique in the child can help us understand if it is linked to autism or developmental differences. It is important to note that emerging evidence can change our understanding of a variant and alter its classification over time. Genetic testing laboratories, clinicians, and patients can share genetic and health data with ClinVar. Sharing with ClinVar can improve our understanding of the relationship between genetics and health. This improved understanding of genomics can help the genetics community classify variants, resulting in clearer results for future patients. Data sharing also helps us to better understand the characteristics of a condition, helping clinicians better care for their patients. By participating in GenomeConnect, you are sharing your data with ClinVar to help increase our understanding of the relationship between genetics and health. As a reminder, when you upload your results to your registry account, GenomeConnect will submit your genetic variant to ClinVar on your behalf. In addition to contribution to our genetics knowledge base, this data sharing could also allow you to receive updates about your genetic test results as new information emerges. If you have not already uploaded your report, we have another video linked in the description below and via the QR code on the screen that walks you through how to upload your report. If you need assistance uploading your results, contact GenomeConnect at info@genomeconnect.org. So why would someone want to search ClinVar? Well, for starters, if you are a GenomeConnect participant, searching ClinVar allows you to see if GenomeConnect has submitted your variant. GenomeConnect submits to ClinVar a couple of times each year. Additionally, you can determine whether others have previously seen your variant, and if so, how they have reported it. Accessing ClinVar is easy for anyone to do. First, go to www.ncbi.nlm.nih.gov. Next, you will need to have your variant ready to search. To find your variant, you will need to look at your genetic test result. This slide includes a visual of a genetic test report. The genetic change highlighted here is listed under the variant heading. Variants are usually written out in a format beginning with C dot, followed by a combination of letters and numbers. This tells us what part of the DNA sequence has been altered. So in this example, we are talking about letter 1 in the CFTR gene. The first letter, A in this example, is what letter people typically have at position 1. The greater than symbol is our way of saying is changed to. And then the last letter tells us what letter this person has at that position. Altogether, this tells us that for letter 1 in the CFTR gene, most people have an A, but in this person, it is changed to a G. This genetic change also can be described by the change in the protein. If you see a P dot on your report, this tells you what the change in the protein is. This P dot MET1 val tells us that amino acid 1 in the protein is typically a methionine. Because of this change in the DNA, this amino acid changed to a valine. Once you have your variant, you can search ClinVar using the format gene semicolon space variant. For example, if one wanted to search for the variant C.1A to G in the gene CFTR, the information entered into the search bar would read CFTR semicolon space C.1A to G. Then hit the search button on the right. A new page will load displaying a ClinVar record. Before continuing, make sure that the gene and variant information at the top of the screen matches the gene and variant information you are interested in. It is possible that the variant on your report and on the screen may not match, since there are many different ways of naming the same genetic change. If this is the case, make sure that the variant on your report is listed under the variant details section in the table next to HGVS on the screen. If you scroll down the page, you'll reach a section titled Submitted Interpretations and Evidence. This section contains a table with different submitters and their classifications of the variant. Looking at this table, it is possible to find that variant classification may differ between submitters. This is not uncommon. It could be because, over time, advances in research may help a submitter better understand the variant, leading to different classifications. If such new evidence has emerged, a variant classification in ClinVar could be outdated. It is also possible that submitters may have come to different conclusions about the significance of the variant. ClinVar is a useful resource to review genetic variants and their classifications. If you have any questions about your genetic testing results, you should contact your healthcare provider or find a genetic counselor in your area by searching www.findagageneticcounselor.com. As a reminder to GenomeConnect participants, remember to upload your genetic testing results to GenomeConnect to ensure that your variant is submitted to ClinVar. We have another video linked in the description below, and that walks you through how to upload your report if you are interested. If you need assistance uploading your results, contact GenomeConnect at info@genomeconnect.org. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please contact our team at info@genomeconnect.org. Thank you.